Someone I just rush like someone I be drinking so. And I go give my cut before I go anywhere.
Go shut to your phone.
That won't be problem to, now.
Go shut to your own shit.
I say that the yarn, I don't see your part one before. Son of the one way you do me last week.
I don't hear. Now you don't get problem.
I tell and I say, any attendant or group of attendants, man, no vote first. What they go?
What they go?
I'm only a few minutes late. He said when you come back, he will be in soon.
Mm-hmm.
Zachariah,
beg. Go buy me rice.
I'm okay.
All right. 40 naira. How much is it?
Yeah, let me just put down. Okay. Hold on, please. I'll just.
Good morning, sir.
There is nothing good enough for coming here this morning, Domitilla. I must warn you. You are digging your own grave.
I think
I have told you that that is not the business of this company. Next time, I won't want you there.
Thank you, sir.
Domitilla. That shiny sailor. He not fit do anything.
You know me now.
Boy, trust now. Don't collect my dollars.
I baby.
Boy, begin fumble.
You know me now. Baby.
Yeah. But wait. You know, say I have one follow before. If not, because your babs. You know, you just dead. I need the guy to look my side.
Waiting. Hey, sweat. You won't compare my dress to Domitilla. That would make me crazy now.
Domitilla, Lord. I have. Oh. You just keep people anyhow, eh? Now, wow, where she get that cloth?
Domitilla. Oh, Bob, here comes our working class girl!
I was so come out that distress office. Now, wait a second. Only people who come Lagos can walk.
Okay? They try. Corporate for money.
Pure for night.
Equals to Operation Mammoth to.
Come on, you suffer all my decent and good girl behavior. You gotta come corporate. Today you come late. Tomorrow you come late. Next tomorrow you go home late. Stop waiting.
Bob, who shall come be home now? He chop Grace. I be no no say you get some bees to settle. You get juice now.
Chill on.
But wait first though.
You go drop something now.
Something.
You know? Domitilla. Dad broke now. You know that?
I drop.
I say everybody for this thing was okay, but you say me can do that, I'll be crazy.
Oh,
Judith, be the answer that your dress. Now, see on the highway now.
But, not be true. Then, not be true. Not be true. You know, you touch light off.
Special pain now.
Happy. Maybe not your answer there.
Corporate lawyer.
Corporate lawyer.
This is Judith. Judith is I must confess, your friends as beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Of course.
Thank you.
Best of
Thank you.
Best of together.
Oh, I agree with
you. Why did you not sit down, please?
Tell me what's been going on with you.
Well, nothing much. Nothing serious.
What do I offer you?
Oh, please.
Let's go inside and have tea.
Yes,
oh.
You know, we're told that negotiations do not last here.
So, sorry, sweetheart. I'm so sorry. I've forgotten my name.
Forgotten my name, Cynthia. John Allego.
Of course, John, it's the Allego I forgot. It's your fault now. You said you were going to come the last time.
Oh, well, I'm so sorry. Yes, I actually had to rush to Abuja for a very serious business appointment.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
It's alright. I just gotta change you to something nice. You know, you promised me.
I have not forgotten. Hello.
Hello.
So, one of your friends.
Yes, one of my friends. She is a nurse. She just came in from her night shift.
A nurse?
Yes.
Oh, that's interesting.
Just give me 1 minute. I'll be right back. Let me change into
okay.
That.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Oh, my bag.
I just want to small one in soup. You see, I know one week you're going to knock my job for me. I think they hear me so because I'm not sending you go to my I think they hear me so. Just fetch because I don't know what they go for anything.
Come as soon as I've been because of that Oshasha guy and I make you call the talk like this. What you come because this?
I don't die. See you now. Until I don't suffer. I don't blame you now. I don't blame you. Because I couldn't curry and carry yesterday and I had to shock your head and you not get before. Nonsense. Sure. I beg babies. Wow. And I can't goof. See personality wise of a problem. How could let this cover play fuck ground? How did you say?
Don't be mean, Nana. Now she will just shake my stash anyhow now.
It's not my fault now. Not me say make the cover drop now.
Please, what? Just it doesn't fuck up anyhow, I beg.
No best now. No,
forget.
Okay, no
now correct
no
cut.
No
correct.
I beg. As long as this move there, so I'm not going to speak clean, expensive English, you know? Yes, until you smile, come up from this house.
Bobs. Yeah, look, I understand you. Why you can't give me back now? I swear to God, I don't sabi na back you.
Sure? I'm give you back her. I'm give you back her. I bet fresh.
Don't hear.
For me, for where you go catch this good-looking mug with a suffer from short-sightedness. So,
baby, I dey work hard. And I test when they work hard, I suppose produce. How you see him?
I am produce. Oh,
take.
But make I talk, Nakuma don't forget the most important thing.
Okay.
You don't forget. You don't check the guy. You know, check the guy. The only thing with me, I see clear with this my coco. How I touch light. The guy, me do this.
He's your nose, eh? Judith, I beg, I say go beg.
What?
Let's say my friend, eh? No go jump around.
You don't get problem.
I beg. No go jump around.
Are you my partner?
That's
you don't get problem.
I want step now, so wait till we can
wear. Step now. That red dress.
Yes.
Sure. Hot red dress.
Polka dot. I mean this one.
Yeah man.
So why did you get me waiting?
Cynthia, I am very sorry. You know I just came back from the office. So I quickly rushed off this to change these new clothes. But I left specific instructions that you be taking adequate care of. I hope you can treat you well. Hey! Johnny! Good to see you! Look, Dad! Oh my God! How are you?
I'm cool.
So, you come to places like
this? Oh, why not? You see, this place is all out for big boys like us.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
So, how are you?
I'm fine, you?
Oh, I'm cool.
That's
cool.
Good.
That's
good.
I'm cool. Who is this?
Oh my God.
Cynthia. Cynthia is a cosmetologist. Cynthia, my very close friend Jeff. We used to be colleagues at the last place I worked before I went to PLC.
We played your pretty woman.
Chef, Chef, I have a new business to discuss with you. That's Chef. Always business. Always business. You never change. You never change. Honey, I'll still be with you. Chef, Chef.
Come, oh boy. Aren't you going too far?
I don't understand what you're saying, Jeff. What do you mean?
Do you have to be seen with her in such places where you are likely to run into your business colleagues?
Jeff, for God's sake, I wish you came down to my level. I don't understand what you're saying. I can't make out anything out of it.
Are you serious? Hey. Come on, Johnny. You know you don't have to play dumb with me. See, I understand. I understand. You see, I patronize them myself too.
You are getting me even more confused, Jeff.
You mean you don't know her?
Who? Cynthia.
Well, she has a right to a million names. But you see, we gentlemen that visit Big Apple, we know her very well. She's a good dish, if you ask me. But man, you don't take her to such respectable places. You will turn yourself into a laughing stock.
I would never have been
Chubby. My supporting angel.
They give me all these
headaches. I say no shaking.
My scoundrels.
I will just serve you, maybe I'll try.
Oh, how do you know?
Kill out the dog. Which one now? You did club season.
I didn't club. I don't see you don't come for that corner with two sheets. So they produce now.
I do jiggle.
Wait, Jean, you do jiggle.
What come now? I don't go see you now.
My short time and carry, I'll not go to DB now.
Nah, sheep matter.
You want to stop now? Tell me that this sheep.
Sure now.
Come. Tonight. You don't say if you tell me it's in a life, we'll just agree, eh? Girls, they yammed me yesterday, say you carry my Tikon club. I'm not saying that, like, just tell me I could believe now.
Nah, come on, you can't come. They can't tell me, say you don't follow Black Zab. That one I shoot better, though.
Tune. Ha! Check your runs now. Now, sis, if you do this kind of thing, too. Tell you they do like something where mad man drop for ground.
But they try to bring my Tikon, they tell me, say
you
don't follow
you
Black Zab.
You for tell me, say, what kind of Tikon club now for can't remove them. How you see them?
Nah, true. Forgive me for matter they for you now. You don't possess.
You don't matter.
I see you. Anyway, I'm not telling you what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to see my baby. You're a brass and I'll tell you. It's me trying to
tell you. Now wait till. Every time when you know me come, you go call you. They go kill me. I think I'll go relax, yo.
Johnny, are you the young like this? Are you the talk like this? Not the money where they want to cure that your sweet father said. I mean, you want me to marry you?
I don't tell you. You hear? Money for school fees. Money for rent. Eh? You won't see me now, see my life. Eh? Anyway, I beg. This is my last father in my life.
How are your friends?
Just do it there. Just.
Is your dad's condition getting any better?
Fact. The old man is going to be in a wheelchair the rest of his life. Every dime I make goes to the doctors.
I'm so sorry. Don't tell her. You're such a strong girl.
God will see you through, right? Say amen.
Amen.
That's better. Now let's forget about Mr. Boss and his query.
Tune your ears to Good News Station.
I'm already there.
Right. You see that my uncle when I tell you it's not Melania?
How do you forget that kind of thing? But, you say that something?
One person just get that kind of person like uncle. Like. I beg you, don't start again. You're doing all right for yourself. You know, sometimes I don't even believe we earn the same salary. What do my uncle name they even do for myself? Pass all the guys when they just want say they won't marry me.
I beg boss Mata Jari. I'll be on the phone with you talk soon. Anyway, Sham, before I forget, the main gist is that my uncle is hosting his friends to a grand party this weekend.
I beg, stop kidding now. What's your own? Look, fat friend, I'll kill them dress. A ravishing girl like you can use a few million.
But I don't stand a chance. You hear me, so? I hear these high and mighties can spot a pretender from a good distance, and their wives
fat trouble something.
Mm-hmm. Look, let me tell you something. This is a different crowd of men entirely. Mm. Who wants to play boys all over again? They will ensure that their wives hear nothing about it.
Sometimes, for hours, I don't see anybody.
Peter!
We go to school
shut
now.
Shut up!
Now school with the
just
go.
Shut up, Peter! I said shut up!
I know. I know that you go to school, yes.
Sister, I want to tell you something. Our teacher said, if we no pay our PTA levy, she then go drive us for school next week.
For me. You don't even sound like a good student anymore, eh?
It's true, sister. The principal announced yesterday at the assembly.
What about the money I sent to you through Tony?
We used it to buy the drugs the new doctor recommended for Daddy.
All of it? Come. Wait.
When I see they plug this money for my backyard, can't give you now. Eh? Why not they spend money like this now for waiting? Eh?
Ngozi, I know how it is for you, for a little girl like you, but it will be all right. It's a matter of time.
It's okay. I'll try and get the money for you tomorrow.
I wanna
give me a thing.
cozy.
Cloth, you mean say you won't wear good at
that? It's the same, you're waiting for where now?
Hey, if you're saying I mean, I go give them fine now. May them bring their meat.
I beg you, may you clear. You no go ever fit be, you hear me so? If you just stay slow.
You no go come out, make a see chance slow. Now, three to two in here, should I make my for free job? If not, you think that I shall have cover with the top for you?
I need something to do you now. Where is the cover? With me. Flow, baby, flow.
Who you dey talk to?
You now, who again?
No mind yourself. See, so you come from that your so-called Mr. Right. You just do like say the whole world won't come to an end.
Bad belle.
Bad belle go kill you. Nothing nice for you, you know, sir.
If you don't get this kind of thing, I go give them wicked move.
Come on. Hey.
It's half black. Mm-mm. It won't kind
go just bounce you come out from the gate. Not safe for you.
Be come out, make a flow, ja.
Bounce. Flow, baby, flow.
You don't know what in there they call. Katako.
Daddy blow.
Make all of una just chill. Make una cack for one country. Because Annie, baby, I must do the flow.
Hey, hey. Funny time.
How are you? I don't know.
Anyway,
be like in French. All of that is speak. As I see so, I go
catch my own.
Domitilla, you're welcome to my humble survey. You've never seen it,
though. Well, I've met your beautiful niece a couple of times. The only snag being that you are still old-fashioned to protect her from genuine wolves like me.
The devil she know. You've not met Dr. Lawson.
Good evening, my dear. I think I'll take a cue from the senator and settle for this Greek goddess called Domitilla.
Fortunately, my niece is grown up enough to take care of herself. I will let her sit you down while I welcome my other guests.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
This is what I call genuine repentance.
Welcome.
Yeah.
necessary if I'm making me. Would it be spear? It's not sister. You know what that stands for?
But I've heard all this. I should have told you.
Mr. Marana, may we leave politics. It's not stress. We've got nothing else.
Okay, let me pray that for you.
Certainly, yes. Domitilla. Come. You are a very beautiful woman. I've said that a million times.
And I have said thank you as many times.
But that is not enough. You should do more than that. You should tell me I'm the handsomest man you have ever met.
Oh, promise me you won't blush.
Every moment, you are a revelation. Yes. I'm happy to have discovered you. Yes. Tell me about yourself.
You haven't said anything about yourself yet.
Now, what is there to say that the newspapers have not said already? Plus lies, mind you.
It's always up to you.
Well, pray that no columnist get crushed this party tonight. As the whole country will know that my latest flame is a tall, elegant girl, young enough to be my daughter.
Is that true?
What?
I mean that you have a daughter like me?
Yeah, she's like you in so many ways. Except that she's spoiled.
Oh.
I spoiled her.
So why did you spoil her?
Because she's my only child.
I'm sorry.
What about? Why are you sorry?
I don't know. Maybe it's the way you said it.
Domitilla, I like you. You have something that I haven't seen in a long time. Yes. Take my card. Call me tomorrow. And that's an order.
I'm not your daughter.
My daughter? She won't even take orders from me. Come on, let's join the party. Let's go and dance. Come on.
What's in
her? Hey, Buna, forget it. You see that your bunga bunga? You know, touch light your face. Check now.
Hey, okay now. Show her something.
Something now.
Show her now. Oh.
Something.
Yes.
Not be by all this worrying and I just do all this bad belly.
I beg you.
My kure kure man is in love with me.
Love? Not see for you. They you fool yourself for death. See this fatty bonbon. I beg.
Come.
Not fool yourself.
You this small and show they carry come from village yesterday.
Me.
I'm not blaming. I'm not blaming.
Blow.
I mean, they come from the
blow. Blow. Blow.
And the same person is supposed to talk to. Yes. Can I help you?
I beg. No, it's not my sister. Don't fool your guy.
You know well for head. Something they walk your brain.
You're
I'm not going to be clear.
right, come on, let's go. All right. We usually collect the money before we leave.
Yeah.
Well, what do you think?
Are you sure we're going to have
what?
Real
fun.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Excellent. What's your name?
Oh, Cynthia, my sister's.
Valerie.
And
Vivian.
Goodbye.
Shut up! I paid you. Now move. Move!
Wait, where are you going?
Move!
Everything.
Yeah. Oh, I never liked that.
Wait, so if I feel the need,
your name now, Jennifer. Jenny for sure. You know the times they change now, and as times they change now, so you two supposed to follow times change, you get? Because you know, see, my name now, Gozi before now, but now they call me Domitilla. Not coming, Gozi, I'll go, wound you, yeah. Domitilla. Let me talk.
Domitilla.
Talk am again.
Domitilla.
Hey, Domitilla. See, eh? See this Lagos. Now money, 9 pesos come find for this place. You get some girls when I know when they do this ashawo job. They don't get anything to show for them. I swear. But me, I come this Lagos come find money. And I make a carry come from village come. You hear me? I won't make you they make the money, then take care of your junior ones. If you like me to make money, we'll go buy latest fashion, eh? When you buy fashion finish, you smoke banner, then your life will spoil. You'll just dabari your life with that. Remember, say, get junior ones when you go, then go university, come back. Oh. Remember your parents, make you just consider them.
Mm-hmm. I promise you, Ngozi, and Domitilla.
Wait, you talk.
Domitilla, I'm not going to disappoint you.
See? Calm down, Coco. You know, Coco, sign me anyhow. I consign you. Would I disappoint yourself? You're not disappoint me. Oh, now you're here today. I just wake up one day, yes, say, you don't catch one correct mugu, you know? When getting money for pocket, let me say, don't turn to your guy, your husband, you know, marriage. Because that is the dream of every genuine ashawo for Lagos. Yes. Mm-hmm. I go take that jeans where Dr. Bernays, nice up, wash up, back well, look. You hear? Not a bed for, come, not a bed for me, yeah? Now Lagos, you did now. You don't get. How are you going for here? All these like bolo things only for village. I wonder what they're teaching for there.
Thank you. I will be back.
I said, now who you be?
So I want to see Domitilla.
Now my sister, now who you come be?
Hello. You say she's your sister. We've just found a body that we want you to come and identify. We found a head without eyes and tongue.
Strange. You won't tell me about it.
They murdered my closest friend.
He killed her.
Murdered? That is very serious. Do you want me to step in? See, I can move the mountains for you. Just say the word. This will be done.
We can have already had the
way. How? When?
Same time. A nice girl like you deserves a better place than this. Okay? When you finish mourning, I'd like to give you a helping hand. Okay? What does your father do?
Nothing at the moment.
I'm sorry. What about your brothers?
My younger one is in secondary school.
All right, Domitilla. Call me anytime from tomorrow morning, okay, in the office. I'll fix something. Perhaps we should start with a decent accommodation, okay? A nice girl like you deserves a better place than what you have here. All right? And then, you can go on to other things. I do admire your courage, you understand? And I want you to always remember that from now on you have me around you. Okay?
Yes, sir.
All right.
You're very kind.
We all get our breaks sometime. Okay? So.
Thank you.
me hard.
Family intervention. Pat told me that you have left your job.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you.
There's no point. We'll try and get you settled somehow. Okay? I want you to have a bank account so that you can adequately take care of your family. Okay?
My father said he'd like to meet you.
Not now. I'll see him at a more auspicious time. Right now, I want you to be able to accompany me to some very important social cause. And therefore, you have to change your wardrobe to reflect your new status.
What about you?
I'm a chief, my dear. Yes. Now, I want you to go and shop for clothes befitting the status of the mistress of a minister to be. Okay?
Oh, mistress.
Yes.
Dad, we'll get you a much more better wheelchair. Computerized.
What difference will it make, Ngozi? Well, I thank you all the same.
Thank you, sir.
You have changed our lives. At least if I die today, I will die a happy man, knowing that I have left my children in the capable hands of their sister.
Dad, you're not going to die until you get up and walk. This looks good on you.
That's true, Dad.
I wish I can believe it. I am happy to have seen God has changed our lives. In all my working years, I have never lived in a beautiful house like this.
Oh, stop it, Dad. Don't spoil the fun.
Don't forget me. Don't forget me, Judith. Oh, why are you talking that kind? How will you forget you, Judith? You don't forget that all of us struggle and labor for inside this house. Anyway, I believe you shall. But you know, since when I meet her, she never lying here again.
Even if you never begin to blame that one, I beg. Let her still the one settled with her husband.
But when I lock you, when I really lock you, Mommy, see me now. Mommy, look me now. Touch like me well now. I see them coming with those stupid strangers every night.
Judith, that's what I've come to talk to you about. See, I think it's our duty to take you away from this dirty life. I don't discuss on Sanita. See, I want to know how you say, deep inside us, we know that what you do not know. Eh?
I don't get choice like you and Anita now. I don't get. Oh God. Why my home gonna be like this? Why? I do anything wrong. But we cannot go marry like Anita.
You just have about your husband now, eh? Don't cry now, I need it.
Oh.
Sit.
Help!
Sit. Judith. I can help you come off of this guy's dirty job.
Sometimes. You know, sometimes. He could just be me like, make I go join Jenny for over there. He could be like, make I do.
Just shut up.
Oh,
Judy. Judy, you still get life. I like it. That's a small good thing. I beg. Try.
Where do you hope? Where do you hope now? I don't carry my eyes here any hope for.
Judy. I never said before some kind of times when you they help mom see sell something for market. If you go try banking now, try those kind of
Bob. What is your answer? Why are you gonna talk like this now? Say make me a come again, go back to that kind of life, bring me for this kind of life again. I know Fito. You don't forget now that life I've been dead before, now bring me back to this kind of life.
Judy, but you supposed to make some kind of small sacrifices now to carry yourself come back to normal life. Judy, I will help you with some kind of small money. Make you start up some small business. How you say?
Don't mean it. See me.
Judy, listen. Remember when Jenny died? Eh? I lost everything. I said I even lose my job. But even before that small determination when I get, I look for fit quit and I quit. Judy, just try. If you just get small feet where God did, eh? Lift you up now. Beg.
Tommy. Don't be afraid to
leave
me alone. Bye. See.
Don't do
me anything. Don't do it.
It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. All I know is that God sent you my way. house like that before. We're always being ejected from one house to the other.
That's bygone now. I'm actually thinking of another house.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mm. This time, for you and me only.
Okay.
Yes. Meanwhile, I've instructed the manager to give you the spare key to this room. Okay?
You want to keep it permanently?
I want us to make it our matrimonial home.
You, sir, are a public figure.
Yes. Not to worry. The proprietor of this place is one of the boys. Come on, girl. Let's toast to our secret marriage.
Marriage?
That's right, girl. Come on.
Come here.
Off. More stupid talk. I think you should keep quiet or go to bed if you have nothing better to talk about.
Jim, I thought we're through with all this.
I wonder why you're bringing this up.
We had a bargain.
I have religiously kept my part of the bargain.
No, you haven't. I know you're steadily seeing one girl and you are not supposed to keep them.
Your informants are wrong.
This is more serious than I thought.
Go on,
you're lying to me, Jim, and you're not even flinching.
I'm going to sleep, okay? I have a meeting at Senator Etienne's house tomorrow morning. Tell her to wait for me. I'll personally drop her at the airport tomorrow morning.
Jim, we had a bargain, and you're acting as if nothing is amiss.
Nothing is amiss. I'm very, very busy with more important state matters to bother about such trivials. Tell your informants to go to hell.
Stop lying to me, Jim. I have the facts. Name, address, everything. She's even an ex-harlot.
You are supposed to be helping my career, not running around and playing James Bond. You are not occupying yourself constructively, and that is a real danger.
How could you do this to me, Jim? You said you won't keep another family mistress after the last experience that almost ruined our marriage.
All right. I have changed my mind.
Morning, Mom.
Good morning, darling.
Where are you going this morning?
Go and put on the dress. We're taking a drive into town.
But I'm supposed to be going back to school this morning.
We should return before your father comes from the meeting to take you to the airport. Make it snappy. We've got to come back, be back within the hour. Would you like to know what we're going to do then? Helen, your father is keeping a permanent mistress in that house. In fact, he rented the house for her.
Mom, don't tell me that's why you brought me here.
We've got to stop him. We've got to stop the affair. He's putting our lives in jeopardy.
And this is how you want to stop him? No, Mom, I won't let you. How could you want you to disgrace my father? You only drag his name in the mud if you do anything with that woman. That is very close to his ultimate political goal.
That's why we must stop the affair. He's going to destroy his career because of her.
not strange in this society.
This one is different. His career will be finished if the press picks on it.
I don't think so. All the world's people are guilty of this offense.
It will make headlines as the scandal of the year.
I think you're making so much out of nothing.
You don't understand. The woman is an ex-prostitute, and your father does not know.
Let's go, Mama. Instead, we have to talk.
That's her. The harlot.
She doesn't look like her.
She wouldn't. Your father has spent a fortune to have taken her.
How did you know all this, Mom?
Find out. The hotel staff told me. And I had a private eye to find out what was wrong. Dad.
Yes.
Mom is not happy with you.
She told you that?
She took me there.
She took you there. Now your mother, she's going too far.
Dad.
Yes.
Promise me you won't do anything that will hurt us.
Of course I won't, but why is your mother doing this?
I know, Mom. She will do anything to keep what is hers. You better be careful, Dad. She may want to hurt that woman.
Bye. Bye, Dad.
Domitilla, I have tried to do my best for you, don't you think so?
Yes.
And it is only fair that you be honest with me. That is what the love affair is all about. Honest and down to earth.
I've been honest with you. I haven't met with another man since I met you.
Why didn't you tell me you were once a whore?
Me? A whore?
Yes.
My life I wanted to forget. And you helped it happen for me, Jim, to forget easily.
Yes. If you genuinely loved me, you should have been able to tell me.
Jim, I didn't want to poison your mind.
Domitilla, you're a very selfish person. All you wanted to do was to destroy me. If I had gone ahead and married you, then one smart journalist would have woken up one day, dig into your past, and destroy what took me a whole lifetime to build.
Jim, no.
Yes. Huh? What?
What is it? Jim. Huh?
Wait.
Jim,
let me know. Come on.
Jim, what's wrong with you? Hey!
Ah!
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim, what is this? Jim! Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Ah.
Jim!
Thank you.
came here to be delivered, sir.
You're only saying that because your fellow fornicator is dead. I don't believe you.
I'm in God's house for Christ's sake. And even if I'm going to die, I just want to have Christ in my life.
Come here. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bring this girl Domitilla to the throne of glory to ask for forgiveness of sins. I come against every contrary and familiar spirit in this temple of God. I bind every spirit, husband, or Obanje, Oloku, Abiku, Queen of the Coast, in the name of Jesus, and I cast you out to outer darkness now in Jesus' name. Out! Never be out. Who are you? Can I help you, gentlemen?
Legal. Go with them.
Listen, you don't have any right to arrest me except God permits you.
Leave him alone. This is just an anointed troublemaker. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Make you they come buy myself from me.
Alright, I'm coming.
Okay, bye bye. Yeah, you
good afternoon.
Where did they come from?
I just the last from police station.
Sit down now.
Don't they take the case, go court on Monday.
Court?
I tell you. I say, when I hear her, body phone you.
What's wrong here? Waiting at the yard before. Why are you not finding out about the man now?
They say na poison.
How can I be called?
You see that my wife? I block her for station. I say that woman a devil.
That will she.
You see, anything where yard police, my police, they just they do for station. They know what green me see them, you. I rake. They bar now.
Which kind of wahala with this, eh? My God, I beg.
I don't think I'm. You know what? Since they can't go court on Monday, eh? Now to get better lawyer, we go defend them for court on Monday, eh?
Yes.
Better one, oh, we go just we go rap. But yawa deal, yawa deal.
It beggars.
That money no deal.
Anyway, that one, now slender matter, heavy slender matter. Eh? Which now they have? See as they shop this. Now, dummy, give me money. We are taking open now. If you mean to make her sell the whole property where they decided to bring dummy out from the house,
you
want.
You said you got a phone call from the hotel manager.
That's true.
That they found Dr. Lawson's body in the hotel.
That's true.
And you were there just about 3 minutes.
That's true.
Now, did you get there that early? Because the corpse was that of a VIP.
That's an irrelevant question. Mr. Atilade, don't waste the time of this court with frivolous questions. Please.
I am sorry, my lord. I am very, very sorry. There is no further question for the accused. Oh, the witness. I am sorry.
Fine. This court will adjourn till Wednesday the 6th.
Oh yeah. Give me the money.
Oh God, they come, I will give you.
I say, give me the money.
They come now. They give you money.
Wait. Shebi, I tell una say, anytime when I come court, una must give me court allowance.
You know their shame. You won't collect money for that nonsense, so you judge inside court now.
See this woman.
You be yeah man.
This woman, waiting concern you.
Now the one when you concern me, I dey talk there.
Waiting concern you. Draw water. I said,
draw water. Don't waste my time. Give me the money.
Tony, now which business you get with this man? If you get any business, do the business.
Give me the money. Look, agreement is agreement.
If my hand touch you. If they
look at this
hand,
woman, no. What concerns you now?
Leave
eh? What concerns you?
Oh my God. I laugh. Okay, you be yeah, man.
Come on, don't waste my time. Don't waste my time.
Make I'm not leaving.
Okay, Tony. I will see you people on Wednesday.
Yeah, man.
May second go back and that coat. See, coat where they like monkey jacket.
Yeah, man.
Leave him. Anita.
Yes.
Everything will be better.
Tony, we don't have to go see that kind of lawyer, safe. You sure say that one a real lawyer?
I want to know, have you wish?
Mrs. Lawson, tell me, how did you learn of the young woman's affair with your husband?
My husband began to act very strangely, like he was under a spell. All his money was going down the drain. So I hired a private detective to find out what was wrong.
Interesting. And what did you find?
I found out my husband was spending a fortune on a well-known prostitute. On the day he was killed, I had earlier gone to her house with the intention to confront her. But my daughter persuaded me not to.
Good.
I did not know she was going to kill my husband.
My lord, that will be all for this witness.
Any cross-examination, Mr. Tilade?
Yes, my lord. Mrs. Lawson, why do you think your husband was leaving you for another woman?
I have just told this court the girl was charming him.
Charm? You mean your husband was leaving you for the girl because you are a very bad woman?
Objection!
Who are you to call me a bad woman? I will deal with you when I leave this court!
Mr. Tilade, how dare you behave so irresponsibly in my court? Your entire attitude in this court is unbecoming of a practitioner of the learned profession.
I am sorry, my lord. I am very, very sorry. It is a slip of tongue.
This court will not condone such irresponsibility anymore.
I am sorry, my lord.
You may go on.
Mrs. Lawson, are you saying your husband is a womanizer?
Objection! My lord, I find this line of questioning totally irrelevant.
You are objecting for me!
Well, well, well. This court is disappointed in your legal abilities. And I'm sure the Bar Association should be too. Well, since it is so obvious that you do not have any reasonable question for the witness, I will have to order a discontinuation of the cross-examination.
As your lordship pleases.
This is ugly publicity for our party chief. Our dear candidate died like a fool in a hotel room with a harlot. My son calls them home.
Do you know the bloody jolly said that I, Chief Judith, a little lost him? I, a harlot merchant? Your son will call me a thief.
Do you know what we're supposed to do? Assume, now pretend us. Nothing strange wrong in it. Like will happen to any and everybody.
Honorable Minister, we don't have a choice.
Senator, your committee is in charge of public relations.
The public, they are stupid. If only they know they can wake up one morning and sack us. All the elite.
What do you think? What will happen to that girl?
You mean the harlot prostitute whore? They will hang her.
I am Mrs. Edith Obina, your new defense counsel. I'm president of the Women's Rights Project. So, do I stand a chance? I'm looking for that chance. Everybody believes I killed him. Tell me, Domitilla. Did you kill him? Are you sure you didn't kill him?
I don't understand. The hotel manager himself brought in the drink.
Manager?
Yes, the hotel manager.
Nobody seems to believe me. All they rejected is that I was once a prostitute.
Do you know anybody who would have liked to kill him?
No. Did you ever hear him? He was so nice a man. Did you ever meet his son?
No. Do you have any other information I might need to help this kid?
Are you sure?
No.
Look, I'm pregnant.
How long have you been in the hotel business, Mr. Achums?
11 years.
11 years? That's ample time to gain a lot of experience, you would say.
Yes.
Mr. Achums, tell us what happened on that day.
I was doing a routine check when I found Dr. Lawson dead in his permanent suite. I then phoned his wife.
His wife? How did you come by her phone number?
I phoned his house and his wife received the call.
Mm-hmm. Does it mean you keep the telephone numbers of all your clients?
No. The late Dr. Lawson was a very good friend of my managing director.
And you thought the best thing to do when you found him dead was to phone his wife?
That's exactly what came into my mind at that moment.
I put it to you, Mr. Apple, that you called that house because it was preconceived.
Objection! My lord, my client is not on trial here.
Sustained. That will be all for this witness, my lord.
You see, my learned friend, this prostitute has no chance. I hope you know what you're doing, Miss Judith.
First of all, mm-hmm. She's a human being.
No.
And she's sweet. Besides, this society is responsible for her predicament. Let's face the fact, child. There are so many Domitillas out there laboring in humiliation. The young lady has told me she's sweet, and I believe her.
You believe her? Well, we'll meet in court. But don't take this personal. Prostitutes, they are not worth it. Hmm?
Sometimes I wonder if it's not the men who specialize.
You tell me.
Ongozi. Were you at any time into prostitution?
But I think I should go take on more Domitilla for this while.
Mm.
Because I know the Domitilla will get her for this thing when she takes the next one.
Everything will be in
your day decision.
And God will pray for her.
Anymore. I don't like courtrooms. Besides, I hate the whole trial.
I don't like courtrooms either. But it's our duty to see the killer of your father prosecuted.
Mom, supposing she didn't kill him. Just supposing she didn't. There's no proof that she did. After all,
your father could not forgive you. Would you have stopped this woman from killing your father? But you persuaded me not to! Now she has scared him and your daddy what she did! I wonder why another person should mean anything to you!
She's a human being, Mom!
Sometimes I wonder whether you come from my womb.
Mom, I'm highly disappointed!
The defense would like to call its best witness to the box.
You may go on.
Miss Helen Lawson.
Mm-hmm.
Muslim and pagan.
I'm a Christian.
This is my time. You pick up on me. I swear by the Almighty God.
I swear by the Almighty God.
That the evidence I shall give in this court.
That the evidence I shall give in this court.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
She has taken the oath.
Tell the court your name, occupation, and address.
I'm Helen Lawson, a part two student of sociology at Ahmad Bello University, Zaire.
Miss Helen Lawson, can you tell this court why you are in the witness box for the defense?
I just found out that my mother killed my father.
Silence in court. Tell us what happened.
Two nights ago, I overheard my mother and the man talking.
Madam, it was a mistake and you know it.
An expensive mistake. You killed my husband and you call that a mistake. You are just a stupid, fumbling idiot.
Madam.
Shut up! You cannot even handle a small issue upon an ordinary prostitute. I don't have any money to waste on a lousy idiot like you. Now get out of here before I throw you out. Get out! I said you should get out of my house!
My mother connived with the hotel manager to kill Domitilla and in the process killed my father.
That's why I killed my father!
Helen! Helen, get out!